Ho, 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 ho. Is that Santa right there? Yes, it is. It is Laser Santa. Why? Because we're going to talk about using lasers in Christmas light shows. Hi, I'm David from Learn Christmas Lighting. And if you're new here, we teach people the basics of how to get started with a great Christmas light show and also sometimes delve kind of into the commercial realm and talk about things like, hey, lasers that can be great for commercial or residential displays. Now, there's a lot of controversy, a lot of misconceptions around the use of lasers in Christmas light shows. And to be honest, to echo an email that I sent to somebody who was asking, you know, many months ago, it can be difficult to get started with lasers in a Christmas light show. So in this video, I want to go top level over the things you've got to know, kind of the pitfalls, the things you really want to know before you do it, so that you know if it's going to work for you or not. Okay, now first is the why. Okay, so whether you've got, you know, a laser like this, this is a big laser that is controlled from lighting consoles or via the ILDA plug on the back, allowing you to control this via DMX, which you could do out of X lights. And this is a laser. This little guy here is also a laser, the LaserCube by Wicked Lasers. Okay, hopefully you can see that there. Okay. Both of these are actually about the same wattage, even though the laser cube is much smaller. And being in that 2-2.5 watt size is a really good size for people just getting started with lasers in Christmas lighting. Okay, so what are the differences? What do you kind of need to know about? Well, when it comes to lasers, there's really two types of laser shows that you see. Okay, you see graphics projection, like this nice Santa we have going on right here, and we'll get to more in a little bit. And then we've got aerial projection. That is when you have fog in the air and you're shooting a laser through the air. Now, pretty much any of these lasers can do either, but how you decide to control that laser is gonna kind of determine the types of effects you're going to get out of it. Meaning that if I'm using DMX and I'm controlling a laser out of X lights, like this X laser mercury laser, I can do projected type images, but that's really not his forte. That's more designed for beams through the air in fog or in haze. Can look awesome for Halloween stuff, but for Christmas stuff, that's generally not the look you're going for. Okay, so let's talk about our friend the LaserCube. The LaserCubes are really cool because they use a program called LaserOS that's free and bundled with them that allows you to do words, pictures, any kind of animation you want. There's lots of them built in. You can build your own, etc. To be able to add a laser to your Christmas show. But I'm getting a little bit ahead of myself. Okay, so let's first, as we get into this, just take a quick look over at the computer at the types of different patterns we can find in LaserOS. Inside LaserOS, there's a whole bunch of stuff. You know, there's visualizers that listen to your music input, but there's also animations. And so I'm in the Christmas folder here, and you can see all of this different Christmas stuff that you can get. Like you scroll down and there's a whole page, and then there's a whole second page. Well, that's a pretty small page. There's also Hanukkah, pretty cool. There's also Easter. Pretty much every holiday you can think of. You can also do things. There's, you know, politics, New Year's, Diwali. There's all this stuff, okay? Chinese New Year stuff, you know, lots of great stuff. Then there's also text, so you can, you know, do things like write. Like here we've got some sort of color effect running over it. And you see there it says Merry Christmas. It's not the best, but it's not bad. And so these are the kinds of things you can do. You can also do all sorts of abstract patterns, okay? As you'll see there, you can bring in images. You can even bring in your own images through the import section. You can save them on timelines or you can also save them via the import function. So you can import SVG or ILD files. There's a lot you can do. Pretty much anything the laser can physically create, you are able to create on your house or in a commercial display. So, anywho, let's go back here to Christmas. Find something nice. Perfect. And so you can probably see, hey, that looks pretty cool on this surface. So when we're using lasers in a Christmas display, they're either going to be on a surface like this, and that's honestly the most common. Just, you know, having it often, sometimes people put these outdoors, rigging up kind of a DIY enclosure for these little cubes, or they'll go ahead, put them indoors, back project onto a window, and have fabric down in front of that window to end the beam and be able to project like this is projecting on this wall. Alternatively, you could project it on a wall inside of a window or something like that. But let's talk about the practicalities, okay? Because this is cool and all, and being able to have a projector that basically is super bright. I mean, we're here in pretty bright studio lighting here in our studio, and this thing has no trouble keeping up with doing these cool animations, okay? So a laser, in particular these laser cubes, can give you some really cool options in Christmas displays. And honestly, you know, the whole reason I'm doing this video is because people ask us about them from time to time, and here at Learn Christmas Lighting and through our other store, Learn Stage Lighting Gear, we are dealers for lasers of all sorts, okay, including these. So let's talk about the practicality elements to using this in your show. First things first is not in skies, not in eyes. So when you get a laser cube, you get the ability to apply for your U.S. variants to be able to legally use your laser here in the U.S. Okay, part of that and part of using lasers legally in the U.S. means that you also get an emergency stop with your laser and keys. Okay, so every day when you start up your show or display, to be compliant with U.S. law for lasers, you need to have the keys in, you turn them on, you press a button to start the laser, you ensure the laser is safe. You're not pointing it in the sky. If you do that, you need to coordinate with the FAA, and nobody wants to do that. You also don't point them into cameras, and the laser beam itself, as per the regulations, has to be 3 meters, or about 10 feet, okay, above any surface that an audience member can stand upon. So that means if you have it in like a closed off room in your house where people aren't going to be, it can shoot lower than that, but anywhere that a person from the public could get to, it needs to be 10 feet over the floor or the land they would stand on. So that basically makes it so that you can do this even if somebody's really tall. They're not going to get their eye in the laser beam because an eye or a camera will be damaged by these lasers. Okay, so, you know, not in skies, not in eyes. You've got an emergency button, an e-stop, that you've got to press every day when you turn on your laser. At the end of the night, you've got to turn it off. Granted, you could technically leave the laser on overnight and just not send anything through it. You need to have, if it's anywhere possibly within the reach of anyone getting, you know, in a position where they could get their eyes in it, you need to have somebody able to press that emergency stop so that when they press it, boom, the emergency stop stops. And that's actually part of the daily checklist for using a laser, is hitting that stop, making sure it works, and then you can restart the laser like I have here, and it'll pop up any second now. Get ready for it. Anybody? And there it is. Boom. Important to test that every day. So you need somebody to test it, to turn it on every day. You need to not have it in the sky unterminated. It needs to end at an object if it's outdoors. It needs to be protected from the elements. That can be very DIY plastic bins with some caulk and a window in it. I've been there many times. There are video projector enclosures and the like that people use. The good thing is these laser cubes in particular are really small. And then the last part is the control aspect, okay? Now, I did a video over on Learn Stage Lighting actually a few years ago about using basically an intermediate program to translate from a DMX signal over ArtNet or SACN to a MIDI signal, which then can control LaserOS. Your other option is if you have either a mercury laser from X Laser or something similar, or you have a LaserCube Wi-Fi Pro, you'll have what's called an ILDA plug, and you could use a program from a company called Pangolin that would allow you, if you have the right one, not the Quick Show, but the Beyond, and it's fairly pricey, but that would allow you to control DMX directly. But we'll link to that video on We're in Stage Lighting that shows you how to use a program called Show Cockpit in the Middle, basically to translate the DMX data that X Lights is sending into MIDI data, which then would trigger Laser OS, which would need to run on a PC for the sake of running your show. So now you've got all the tools you need, and so if you've been interested in using lasers in your light show, then hey, hopefully this helped you today. Does it sound cool? Is it something folks are interested in? If so, I'll do more stuff on it in the future because we love to help people. And if not, hey, we'll just let this go by the wayside, but I think it's something that people are definitely interested in. And a laser cube, it's kind of like a Fobbles machine, but even more fun because you can do so much with it. You know, between shooting a clock on the wall, playing games, you know, having a kid's birthday party to play games up on the wall or the ceiling in your house, you know, being able to do a birthday message for a friend outside their house when they come home. There's so many different cool things you could do with the laser cube that, you know, really allow it to be a fun thing to work with year round. And so if you need one of these, hey, we've got them in stock. We would love to help you. Check them out. We'll have them on the Learn Christmas Lighting Store. We've got them on the Learn Stage Lighting Store, and we'd love to help. If you need anything else, of course, for your Christmas lighting, or you're just brand new to this, head over to learnchristmaslighting.com. We've got a free guide we want to get into your hands, and check out our store where we've got all the things to make a display. Thank you guys so much for watching. Have a great day, and we'll see you in our next video. Thanks.